Hi there, and welcome to shigaru.com. Today we're going to have a quick look at the song by Ellie Goulding and Calvin Harris called Outside. It's a really catchy song. It's a very easy song. It's only got four chords, and they just repeat over and over and over again. It's got a couple of bar chords. Well, it's got three out of the four bar chords, so this is a really good song to practice your bar chords if you are just beginning. So first of all, we'll look at the chords, how to form them, and then we'll look at the strumming pattern. And as I said, this is a really quick lesson. Please give this a thumbs up if you managed to learn the song and if it helps you out a little. And please subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. Release all kinds of different stuff every other week, so subscribe. And let's begin with the lesson. Okay, the first chord you're going to need is an A chord. And that's just your first, second, and third finger on the second, third, and fourth string of the second fret. And then you'll need an F sharp minor, and that's just barring all the strings on the first, on the second fret, and then with your third and fourth finger, place them on the fourth and fifth string of the fourth fret. And as I say in all my videos, just push your shoulder into the guitar if you're having problems forming those bar chords. It will just add a bit more strength behind your fingers. And then you'll need a D flat minor, and that's just barring all the strings on the fourth fret, and then you place your second finger on the second string of the fifth fret, and then your third and fourth fingers on the third and fourth string of the sixth fret, and that's a D flat minor. And then you'll need a B chord, and that's just barring all the strings on the second fret, and with your second, third, and fourth finger, you place it on the second, third, and fourth string of the fourth fret. And those are the chords, and those chords repeat over and over again in that sequence. A to F sharp minor to D flat minor to B major, and then back to the A. Okay, so let's just have a quick look at the strumming pattern now. Okay, the strum, for the most part, you can do downward strokes. So you start with the A, and then to the F sharp minor, second fret, then to the D flat minor on the fourth fret, then the B major on the second fret, and back to the A. Sharp minor, D flat minor, B major. And that chord sequence, as I said, repeats throughout most of the song. The only thing you can do once the song gets going is you can mix up the rhythm a bit. So I do something like this. So I carry on with the downward strokes. So all I'm doing there is I'm doing the downward strokes on the A, and when I'm ready to change to my F sharp minor, I start the F sharp minor with a down up down, and then go back into the downward strokes. So it's hear that, so it's down up down and then down, so it would be, and then when I finish that, I go to the D flat minor on the fourth fret, and I do exactly the same thing, down up and then downward strokes, and when I'm ready, I go to the A chord, to the B major, and I do the same thing, I do down up to the A chord, and I do it again, so and it just jazzes it up a bit, because this is all kind of keyboard type dance type of tune, not really made for the guitar, so it's just something you can do just to juice up the song a bit. I'll accentuate a bit for you now. Thank you. that's it really, and you just go throughout the whole song. There's a slight pause towards the end of the song, and there's this part in the song where it gets a bit softer, and all you need to do is just play a little bit soft, softer, more softly, and then gradually pick up the intensity again as the song develops again. And then, as I said, there's a slight pause in the song where you stop on a certain chord, which you'll see. I'll play the whole song through, and I'll put the chords up on screen, and they'll appear as you need to play them. And that's it, really. You just, those four chords nearly all the way through to the very end of the song. It's that easy. So good luck with that. Good luck practicing your bar chords. And if you have any questions, any doubts, just leave your comments below. And yeah, great. I'll see you at the next song.